Hello everyone, in this video I am going to explain how to cite check of the created instance using AWS. In this previous video I explained how to install an instance using Jenkins. To start this sanity check, log in into AWS account. After login, in the dashboard, on the right corner, you will be able to find the region. Select the region for which the instance was created. You can cross-check the text file to make ensure the region. Once you select the region, now click the EC2. It will take you to the next page where you have to see the running instance details. Click on running instance. Then it will display all the instance which you have created already along with the newly created instance. Then it will display the all instance. Here you select your newly created instance. If you check the checkbox, it will display the all the details which you have given in the text file using which the instance was created through the Jenkins. In the details, you will find out the security group. If you click on the security group, it will take into the next page. Then in that page you need to click the inbound. By that way you can check the port what you mentioned in the text file will be matched with the what are the port it will be open. Now you go back to the previous page, select the checkbox for the newly created instance. You can find the newly created instance by the instance name, and you can check the region name, public IP and other details. Now you can click the connect button. In that pop-up window, you have to make sure a standalone interface client is selected. It will show the command to connect the instance and it will show the PIM key. Make sure your PIM key, what you've given in the text file, will be matched with the instance. Copy the command and paste in the command prompt. By that way, you will be able to connect the instance. On connecting the instance, it will ask the security because the instance not made the establishment previously. So it will ask the prompt you want to ensure yes. By that way you are able to connect the instance. Once the instance is connected, you are able to view the install dependency like that. Now you can check the software which given for the installation through the text file. I will now show the version check of the node by giving the command node-v. So let's be sure about the node is installed properly. By the same way we check if the git install or not. By that way we will check all the dependency what we mentioned in the text file is installed or not. we check Node, Git, Nginx, MongoDB. These dependencies are installed properly. Then we check we able to connect the MongoDB. So now the MongoDB connection is established, and we will check if the database what we taken from the S3 bucket is untar and restore properly or not. So in that S3 bucket we mentioned the database name as here Neo, so it will properly restore. Other database or the predefined database for the MongoDB. So now be sure about the dependencies are installed properly. Now we will check that project is cloned or not. Let's move into the project folder. In the folder there we mentioned 5 applications. So the 5 applications cloned properly, and we will check that NVM is installed or not. So we will check for one application like a student app, where that node module is installed from the package JSON via our Jenkins. So now we sure about all the applications installed properly. We will check the application is up or not. Yeah, we mentioned here in the previous video we use forever to make the application run backgroundly. So we give forever list, so the all application came up properly. So now the applications are running properly. Now let's we check the database take the backup properly or not. Let's we move to the DB. So the database also taken properly at the time of 7:18 today. So the database will be take for the every 5 minutes. So now we sure about the dependency application and database working properly. So let's we move the database backup is moved properly into S3 bucket or not. Here we mentioned the bucket name as Neo Testing AWS. So we move click the bucket name, then we go with the DB backup. Here the backups are taken frequently. Here we map the backup what we taken from the terminal like Mongo 2018 5 31 13 18. Mongo 2531 3080. So the backup is taken properly in S3 bucket. Next we need to check the domain name map correctly or not. So we need to move into the route 3. In the text file we give domain name as dev.student. So we need to move into host zones news.com. Here all DNS will be listed. Here we need to check our so it will show the dev student. Sorry, we give up here. Yeah, we will check like that public IP 35183392199. So the IPs are mapped properly. So by that Jenkins service, be able to create a instance and install the dependency, and the project will map, application will map with the domain name. So using the service, be able to do whatever we want. Then let's go with monitoring. Monitoring, if the issues happen, then it will send that mail to the user. Send us your queries and suggestions to sales@testonly.com. Took connection with us on Twitter, LinkedIn account. Do not forget to subscribe our channel for more videos. Stay tuned. Thank you.